And welcome back to the show. I am Vishal Vagh, Director Marketing from Adam Fabriwork, welcoming you to the show. We will be going through a presentation of processing system for creams and ointments, particularly for pharma. So we will make it interesting with a video. So here goes. Well, what you see here is a typical cream and an ointment plant for capacities ranging up to 10,000 kilos or 10 tons. The center one that you see is a vessel, and the two vessels on the sides are the phase vessels, typically the wax and the water. Now, in many markets, there is only one slurry vessel which is used. But most of the time in India and a few markets, we have seen usage of a separate water and a separate oil or a wax vessel. So these are used independently. In some formulations, they are combined in a slurry form and only one phase vessel is used. The applications for the process kit are used as with in pharmaceuticals as well as in cosmetics. So it could be cold creams. We are talking about emulsions, lotions, gels, shampoo, but creams, ointments also are used. It can also be manufactured for toothpaste. Within the system, there is for each vessel an option for heating and cooling with insulation. There is temperature control with safety features built in into the system so that for critical products, temperature does not overshoot the set points within the system. The special feature that you see here is a short recirculation path for smaller batches. This is very important for processing smaller than half the volume of the batch size of the vessel. So if the vessel capacity is 1,000 kilos, and let's say if you have to process 400 kilos, then this short recirculation loop takes care of the shorter recirculation. This ensures that the product comes through the path directly into the vessel without charring or without any damage during the heating cycle. There is hydraulic lifting for the top dish of the vessel to take the top lid up. There are transfer panels also to facilitate CIP of individual vessel. A transfer panel is a system in which lines are connected from the CIP skid and they are redistributed to different points within the vessel. So the spray ball of each of the vessel of the manufacturing, wax, water, as well as the storage vessel is connected through the transfer panel, and it is a fail-safe mechanism for cleaning in place of the process vessels. And it ensures that at any point of time, you can carry out batch operation within the vessel and carry out CIP of the other vessel at the same point in time. CIP also is a part of the system. The conical design of the bottom of the manufacturing vessel ensures the lower batch sizes are possible within the manufacturing vessel. It's also ease of cleaning, and it ensures high degree of CIP ability and SIP ability for specific operations. All the three vessels, the wax vessel, the water vessel, and the manufacturing vessel, are completely built with vacuum, and they are provided with an integrated vacuum system, which gives variable vacuum levels, a full flush possibility within the vessel, and it ensures that all the raw materials within the system are sucked by vacuum, and there are no needs of specific pumps for sucking in raw material. The touchscreen HMI is easy to use, large, and the user interface is operator friendly. These are, of course, provided with SCADA options, with supervisory control and data acquisition. They are also customized for specific levels of software, and the configurations are made flexible and again highly customized for particular operations to suit critical products. The high shear head within the vessel also is with a fan and a screen arrangement system. It is vertically or side mounted, which generates shears and drives the product flow, also discharges the batch specifically when it is in the bottom configuration. Now, this is fitted with a variable speed drive, which ensures variable shear force on the products which are manufactured. It also ensures complete de-agglomeration of the product, through which the product de-agglomeration is done, and the anchor with the scrapers gives a complete mix within the manufacturing vessel. Typically, while starting a batch, carbomers or powders or waxes are sucked into the vessel or inserted through the manhole. These are powders which are sucked in under vacuum, and then they are melted. The advantage in this operation is that there is no use of drums or any other thing for opening through the manhole. They are melted at a temperature of 75 to 80 degrees. The water phase vessel also works on the same principle. Water is taken into the vessel, and then specific carbomers are added into the vessel and dissolved into the water through a bottom sawtooth cutter, a propeller, or a high shear mixer, as the case may be. All mixer configurations are customized for specific operations. Again, the advantage of transfer by vacuum cannot be replaced by any other mechanism. Once the wax and the water both are ready, they are sucked into the manufacturing vessel by vacuum. There is no pump required for transfer from water to manufacturing or wax to manufacturing. While these two transfers are taking place and the entire product comes into the manufacturing vessel, it is moved across by the anchor within the vessel. The anchor that you see here is a semi-contra rotary design with floating scrapers on the sides, which are adjustable as per the load pushed onto the scrapers. The semi-contra rotary agitation system also has a huge advantage of mixing products at a very faster speed than other agitation systems. In case of very high viscosity of product like 300,000 or 500,000 centipoise, we also offer agitation options of contra rotary for these applications. The wax and the water is moving today now at 75 and now being cooled. It also goes through an internal recirculation where temperature is reduced from 75 to 35 or process temperature as per the batch. This is where the emulsion is formed by combining the wax and the water. The drug is added, drug API color or the perfume as the case may be, is added from the top. Once the product is cooled down, you can see the anchor moving very slowly to ensure that mass movement is carried out, and this moves the product within the vessel and it's scraped from the walls of the vessel. It is very important to note that the high shear is not operated once the emulsion formation is done. Over operation of the high shear may also lead to low viscosity or damage the product of the system. Once the product is manufactured and cooled down and the API or the drug is added and mixed, the product is ready to be transferred to the storage vessel. You see here a mobile storage vessel into which the product is transferred, and this transfer takes place through a twin lobe pump, which is a sanitary cleanable in place design. And this transfers the product from the outlet of the manufacturing vessel to the. The storage vessel also is a completely hermetically sealed process vessel, which has spray balls for cleaning within the system, and it ensures complete CIP ability. The batch storage vessel also moves from the manufacturing area to the filling machine room, thereby transferring the product in a closed contained atmosphere. It is not advisable to connect through a pipeline going from the manufacturing vessel to the filling machine unless you have a pigging system in place or the volumes are very large. Typically, in pharmaceutical applications, There are back storage vessels which do the transfer mechanism from manufacturing room to the filtration or the filling machine room, and the products are transferred by a transfer pump to the filling machine. Well, this was a system courtesy from NCube Ethicals, where we have many of our manufacturing systems in operation. It is important to the design of the system reduces the processing time of the emulsion to a large extent. It also helps to ensure that the product is manufactured under a safe zone. There are different options and L by D ratios to which the manufacturing system can be designed, keeping in view existing layouts and existing conditions. Of course, there are spray balls and spray devices also within the manufacturing vessel, as well as the vacs and the bottom, which ensures cleaning efficacy within the system. There are user configurable CIP recipes which also ensure complete cleaning cycles of the process system, which can be customized for each product. A complete system moves through a series of automation cycles of modular operations of vacuumizing, mixing, checking the weight, and then the high shear, as well as the transfer, to ensure that the product that is made is compliant to the recipe cycles that have been designed by the R&D team and the pilot operations which have been carried out. The same scale can be scaled down from a larger batch size to a lower batch size of 50 kilos and can be manufactured in a R&D batch size of 5 kilos. And this can be scaled up all the way to 1000 kilos or 10,000 kilos. Essentially keeping the geometry and the tip speed with the shear rates of the agitation system as a constant. Well, here we are. Any questions?
Thank you for the session. No questions.